إن إبراهيم كان أمة قانتا لله حنيفا ولم يك من المشركين. بارك الله لنا ولكم في القرآن العظيم ونفعنا وإياكم بالآيات والذكر الحكيم إنه تعالى جواد كريم ملك بر رؤوف الرحيم. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that I took Ibrahim as my friend. Now, for Allah to say that I took Ibrahim as my friend shows something very special, unique, and wonderful about this great man Ibrahim Khalilullah. You know, when Allah says, I have made him my friend, okay? I took him as my friend. Why? Because he is loyal. He is faithful. He does what he says. He truly believes in my glory and in my greatness. He truly has submitted himself, surrendered himself to me. He bows before me. He does what I say to him. His heart is with me. His heart is full of my love. وَاتَّخَذَ اللَّهُ إِبْرَاهِيمَ خَلِيلًا. And Ibrahim showed all these signs of being loyal, of being a courageous person, and someone who was truly in love with Allah. And I want to, as I said, there are, Ibrahim is mentioned 73 times, and there are at least 10 main passages where Ibrahim's stories are mentioned, one or another. Today I've selected this particular one from Surah Al-An'am, where Ibrahim has a go at his people, okay? His qawm, his people, are idolaters. They worship idols. And this is Mosul. Today's Mosul in Iraq was the city in which he lived. This was the center of the star worshippers, sun worshippers, and their emperor Nimrod was their mighty representative proxy god. Okay, so he lived in that city of idolatry, and his own family was actually involved in idol manufacturing. Okay, so he was very familiar. And he was actually appalled, and perhaps this is why, you know, he would see his family mixing the clay, you know, the dust with water, and from that making their own gods, okay? So he knew the absurdity, the foolishness of this from very beginning. But here, you know, Surah Al-An'am, Allah shares with us one of the incidences that took place, and I'm sure these would have been numerous in his life. Just listen to how Ibrahim Khalilullah tackles the idol worshippers of his people. And just see the logic, the rational, and also, you know, the eloquence of this. Okay? So here Allah says that Ibrahim, وَإِذْ قَالَ إِبْرَاهِيمُ لِأَبِيهِ آزَرَ أَتَتَّخِذُ أَصْنَامًا آلِهَةً إِنِّي أَرَاكَ فِيكُ إِنِّي أَرَاكَ وَقَوْمَكَ فِي ضَلَالٍ مُبِينٍ. And remember when Ibrahim said to his father, Azar, that, and his people, he said to his father, Azar, and his people, you've taken idols as gods? He's asking the question, you've taken idols you make with your hands as gods? So he's actually showing surprise, and he's showing, how weird is this? How foolish is this, really? That's what he's saying. He's being satirical here, Jan, no? إِنِّي أَرَاكَ وَقَوْمَكَ فِي ضَلَالٍ مُّبِينٍ. I see all of you and all the people. You are absolutely wrong. You are absolutely wrong. I hope you can see this courage, you know, this brave and bold stand that Ibrahim takes against his own people. And I think, we know why that is, because Ibrahim is prophet of God. He's the messenger of God. He's been nurtured. He's been made, you know, with pure heart and with a lot of intelligence, okay? He just couldn't, you know, so you couple the prophethood and the power of his reason, and of course his courage and boldness. Okay, you know, many of us are not bold sometimes. You know, we can't speak out for the truth, we can't stand up for the truth. Okay, but Ibrahim stands up for the truth. And some people here will question my translation that, you know, he said, "Is qala li Ibrahim li abihi," he said to his father. Well, that is what the Quran says, all right? And in the footnotes, I've put that abihi is translated and understood by some commentators as being the uncle, okay? Because his own father, Tariq, was most likely, you know, the Mufassirin say, was a believer, okay? So the, but I can't translate uncle when it says father, right? That would be wrong. I have to translate it as it is. However, in the footnotes, I've made it clear that Abi is regarded as the uncle of who he's talking to, who was the mushrik, okay? But his father, as I said in my footnote, is a Tariq who was a believer, okay? So, you know, it's just that people sadly present, you know, wrongly, and they try to fool people, okay? Even Allah Hazrat has translated this as Baap Jaina, because he couldn't translate it as uncle. How could you translate Abi Jaina as uncle? It just shows it's not. However, in the footnotes, you know, the Alama Naimuddin Muradabadi wrote that this means the uncle Jaina, as I have done Jaina. Anyway, that's not a, you know, it's so sad that, you know, we have to focus on things that are less important and we leave the real message, eh? Can you see what the message is about against idolatry? But how people wrongly portray and misunderstand and try to fool people. And I hope you should be intelligent enough to see how dangerous these people are. People who do this, they are supposed to be alims. What are they trying to do? They're trying to fool people, eh? And they are the ones who are doing tahrif. If anything, they are trying to do the tahrif, not me, no? I presented what is the truth and what is right here, yeah, no? But anyway, may Allah guide those people who are trying to take our tawajjuh and our focus from the message of the Quran and want us to focus on polemics, which they themselves sadly don't even understand, okay? That's the sad thing about it, yeah, no? Anyway, the real story, it's so sad that we forget the real story. The real story is this. So Ibrahim alayhi salam says, he says, Allah says, وَكَذَلِكَ نُرِي إِبْرَاهِيمَ مَلَكُوتَ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ. This, like this, we showed Ibrahim the realm of heavens and the earth. In other words, we showed Ibrahim the realm of heavens and the earth. You can just imagine what insights Ibrahim had in the workings of this wonderful universe, okay? How he understood and how he saw the heavens and the earth. What knowledge he had, what insight he has. Me and you can't actually understand what that was. No scientist can explain to you what knowledge and what insights Ibrahim had about the creation around him. So, what does he do? وَلَيَكُونَ مِنَ الْمُوْكِنِينَ. We did this so that he becomes muqineen, someone with yaqeen, someone who firmly believes in the truth. And we know that Ibrahim believed very firmly in Allah. Then the Quran tells us, فَلُمَّ جَنَّ عَلَيْهِ اللَّيْلِ. When the darkness of the night came, he saw kawkaban, he saw the stars. And what did he say? He said, هَذَا رَبِّي. So he saw the stars, and this is my Lord. Who is he talking to? He's talking to his people. He's talking to people around him. And perhaps, you know, we know that Ibrahim, as I said to you, he was wonderful, eloquent speaker, most knowledgeable amongst them. They appreciated and saw, they would spend time in his company. So this is a starry sky. And he said, ah, there is my God. What is he doing? He's being satirical, okay? He's actually he's exposing the folly of these people. That's what satire is. You expose people's madness, their foolishness. Oh, that is my God, eh? But after some time, the star vanished. And he said, oh, I don't like things that vanish, that set, I don't like them. And then the Quran says, فَلَمَّا رَأَ الْقَمْرَ بَازِغًا. Then he saw the moon shining. And he said, this is my Lord. This is my God. And then when the moon set, he said, If my Lord hadn't guided me, I would be misled. Okay? He said, this God has also vanished. And then, فَلَمَّا رَعَ الشَّمْسَ بَازِغَةً. And in the morning when he saw the sun rising, he said, هَذَا رَبِّي هَذَا أَكْبَر. Well, this is the biggest of all. Bigger than those stars, more brighter than the moon. This must be my Lord than Jannah. فَلَمَّا أَفَلَتْ قَالَ يَا قَوْمِ إِنِّي بَرِيءٌ مِّمَّا تُشْرِكُونَ. When that sight, he said to the people, I'm free of your shirk, of your idolatry. I have nothing to do with you. I've got nothing to do with you people, Jannah. إِنِّي وَجَّهْتُ وَجْهِيَ لِلَّذِي فَطَرَ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ. I turn my face towards the creator of heavens and the earth, حَنِيفًا. Solely to him, وَمَا أَنَا مِنَ الْمُشْرِكِينَ. I'm not one who associates anyone with my Lord. You know, you can see this satire that is poking fun at them. And of course, they stood up for their banavti gods. So they stood up for their idols. And they said, oh, Ibrahim, you better be careful. وَحَاجَهُ قَوْمُهُ. As people began to argue with him, challenge him. How dare you argue about our gods, Jannah? And he says, أَتُحَاجُونِ فِي اللَّهِ وَقَدْ هَدَانِي. You want to argue with me once Allah has guided me on the true path? وَلَا أَخَافُ مَا تُشْرِكُونَ بِهِ. I'm not afraid of your gods. I'm not afraid of you either. This is the boldness. You know, this is the courage of Ibrahim. He says, I'm not really afraid. Your gods can't do anything to me, okay? Neither can you do anything to me. وَسِيَ رَبِّي كُلَّ شَيْءٍ عِلْمًا. My Lord has the knowledge of everything. أَفَلَا Are you not going to listen? He's still, can you see the power he has and the courage he has? Are you not going to listen and are you not going to take heed from this? وَكَيْفَ أَخَافُ مَا أَشْرَبْتُمْ. I'm not going to be afraid of those things that you have made because I have what? I have arguments. I have reason on my side. I have seen the reality and the truth. You are wrong. فَأَيُّ الْفَرِيقَيْنِ أَحَقُّ. Which group is the truthful one? You or me? I'll tell you, I am the one. And then, الَّذِينَ. This is a really beautiful ayah which tells us something about our faith. الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَلَمْ يَلْبِسُوا إِيمَانَهُمْ بِظُلْمٍ. Those people who don't confuse their faith with shirk. Those who don't confuse their faith with? Shirk. Ah. You know, this is something, you know, we think that shirk is just having these idols, worshipping these idols or the star or the moon or the sun or the fire. But don't be fooled. You know, sometimes our wealth becomes our gods. Our careers become our gods. Our family becomes our God. Doesn't it? Yes, it does. You know, it becomes a God in the sense that, you know, it becomes the central focus of our lives. Our lives begin to revolve around these things. When that happens, that too is a shirk, okay? And what does Allah say here? الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَلَمْ يَلْبِسُوا إِيمَانَهُمْ. Those who believe and they don't confuse, you know, their faith with وَلَمْ يَلْبِسُوا. Don't mix it. Don't confuse it. You know, with zulm. Zulm here doesn't mean just wrongdoing. Actually, it means shirk. You know, as mentioned in Surah Luqman, you know. أُولَٰئِكَ لَهُمُ الْأَمْنُ وَهُمْ مُهْتَدُونَ. These are the ones who will have security. These are the ones, you know, who will be truly guided. Those whose iman is clear and not mixed up. You know, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us the courage of Ibrahim Khalilullah.